round two in a fifth, and now round three, they're in the cup final. That's a steep learning curve right there.
Take a look at the results there as they make their way through. A very close one against England, and then that French victory was absolutely sublime from the US Eagles, winning 14 points to 10. That's their pathway here into the cup final. And meanwhile, Russia, they've been physical, they've been battered. They have nine players left that are still standing, and those are nine brilliant players. Well, for them, take a look there, 26-5 over Poland. But the game of the tournament so far, they beat Australia, 29-26. Australia, double gold medal champions. Well, they won't be competing for the final. This side will. Our official is Julian Zussman from Canada, former international player and now international referee. Alina Tehran is ready, the captain, so is Alana Mar. It is the HSBC Spain Sevens Women's Cup Final. And the 2022 season will see a new champion for this tournament in the women's competition. US on the radio screen in white received this one. And straight away, it's Mark, player from Vermont in the USA, known as the Vermont Volcano. Chris Thomas comes to the short side. Kershey gets a start. Christy Kershey, big strong bump from Kershey, the New Englander. Advantage for the US early on in this game. Crossfield they go with their skipper. Nice little angle comes in again, is Alona Mar in support. Go across with Kayla Kinnett. Doyle, and now here's the speed merchant, Nyla Tapper. Nyla Tapper, who broke Lev Kelter's try scoring record. Top try scorer now for the US of all time. Good passenger play here for the Eagles with Thomas in play. Chris Thomas, here we go. This will be a race. Thomas for the line. And the US Eagles start out with a bang in this cup final.
Oh, what a line there, round by Chris Thomas. The Russian defense there was a little bit out of sorts. You just see a bit of a dog's leg created. Yep, number nine there for Russia. She just got caught biting in, leaving that bit of a dog's leg, which was exposed so well by Chris Thomas, running that in. What a great way for the USA to start.
Chris Thomas adds try number 78 for her country. What a fight she has been, the 28-year-old, over the years. 2017 Rugby World Cup Dream Team is on 15s. They're up 7-0 of the US. 1.5 gone in the first half. Russia to receive. First real opportunity for them. They take this superbly at the top by Serendina, the Olympian. Russia now, chance for them. Baranchuk moves it across field. Big dummy in midfield. Victoria M has really come alive in this tournament. Celebrate her birthday earlier this week, and Russia get the penalty. So they tap. Quick hands from them. Hamidova, this is one of their stars. Hamidova looking to go on the outside. Oh no, this is amazing! How did she get around? It's Bayzat Hamidova that has stunned everybody, and Russia strike back.
Oh, Hamidova, that is a classic try from her. She's so deceiving with her bend. She will flirt as close to that sideline as possible because she backs her strength, her ability to fend players. But then she's also got that speed to pull away. She's been key for them this weekend. Sixth try of the tournament. Gets them back into contention.
Bayzat Hamidova, eighth highest try scorer of all time. The Russian leader with 119 tries to her name. Kick will go to the side, 7-5. And Hamidova, well, what a player. Her sister, Navrat, played sevens for Russia as well. Those are the stats at this tournament. An HSBC Dream Team. In 2018, first Russian to score 100 tries. We have a game on our hands. We knew we would, as any cup final delivers. Kershey to receive this. Runs out from a 22 for the US Eagles. Little tap there from Kayla Kinnett from San Diego, California. Gets a little switch to Doyle, the veteran of the side. Lauren Doyle down there. Of course, without a Lev Kelter, playing 15s in the United Kingdom. Ma, Alona Ma, one of the tries of the tournament she scored yesterday, and here comes another cut back inside. Nyla Tapper cuts like an insult, and the US Eagles have their second.
It's simple sevens, but when it's executed that well, it'll tear any defense open. It was hands, but it was at pace with accuracy. A lovely little delay on the pass there from Alona Ma, just making sure she gives the absolute most amount of space to be exposed there out on the wing, and she just cuts back in the exact right time.
Conversion is successful from Nicole Haviland and Naya Tapper, a player that has scorched this earth. There she's there, two away from 100. A remarkable achievement. And the restart comes down to the US Eagles. They did knock that one on, so Russia have Hamidova, spots a gap. And again she goes low to keep possession for the Russian side.
No advantage gained, two knock-ons, first by White, then by Red.
Initially a really good challenge in the air there by Chris Thomas. Gets up really high, gets that tap back, but unfortunately Russia just get the most from it. Really nice, two-handed full stretch.
Stability.
Oh, there's a question. Could she have maybe actually taken that one? She wasn't around. There wasn't much pressure around her. She went for the tap back. Russia get possession.
So Russia.
Set.
They've played in two cup finals, lost them several years ago. This would be remarkable. They can come back in this game like they did against Australia, where they won 29-26. To the outside they go. Daria Noritsina played in the Olympic Games for the Russian Olympic Committee. They finished eighth, the USA in sixth. Different story right now as gold is on the line. Hamidova in midfield. Chris Thomas flies up, so does Tapper. They've got to stop the threat. Alina Tiron comes in. Again, they go through Burenshuk. Russia with a minute to go in the first half. Across field, Seredina floats it forward.
Just a bit of a miscommunication there between the outside backs for Russia. You could see they wanted to get the ball into the wide channels, but unfortunately she had to sort of float it in front of the player that offered her a short line. Split second earlier, that front player could have just passed in front, holding the defence. The ball could have gone behind her.
Tense times and tense moments. And that's Emily Bidewell, the US new head coach. And what a position she's put aside in into the final. With 10 players left, mentioned 9 for the US. The US won in Biarritz in the 2019 season and Glendale in 2020. It's been a long time since then. Here they come with Kinnett, a new crop of players as well. Lauren Doyle, low on the ground as Victoria M comes into pinch position, but hands are in.
Oh, that's frustrating. Initially, really good defense there from Russia. Led by Victoria M, rushing up, trying to get that ball. Just hands in the ruck.
Well, it's been 950 days since we've been in Europe for a women's tournament. It's a welcome return here. I'm not saying that just because it's snowing where I live, but the beach in the distance, the players have been. There's a brilliant little tattoo of the Eagles. The US Eagle doing her proud. Players have thoroughly enjoyed their time here at the HSBC Spain 7 Sevilla next week inland. But business to finish here. Last moment of the first half. US up 14 points to 5. Haviland goes to top in, pinched by Russia. Here they come. Can they score a second before the break? M drifts on the outside, gets a nice little switch, but the defense is there from Doyle. Comes in on Noritsina. Burenshuk moves it away. I've seen a lot of Tiron so far. Hamidova, though, goes into a huge stumping tackle from Alona Mar. He tries to fire back one in again. Burenshuk, strong. Looking for the wave yet again. Serendina, little jump over. Noritsina, the angry fend to the halfway line. The US have defended well so far. Can Russia crack this, though? They look to cut back in with Burenshuk. Again, quick hands. Cool cover, there's space to work here. Serendina, Victoria M on that far side. Again, it's physical contact. Russia have worked their way up to the 22. A long passage of play here. Alina Tiron, can she do something special? Offers a switch to Hamidova. Those two working in tandem have been a thrill to watch over the years, but the counter-ruck comes in. It's huge work from Tapper and Alona Mars. Play on, here comes Russia on this side. Kulkova has pinched it. Snezhana Kulkova has got the second try for Russia in the cup final.
Wow, what a try. Credit to Russia. I mean, the Hooter had gone down where the line-out was happening. And how many phases ago was that? They kept the ball alive. That is energy-sapping stuff. And when we've said before, you know, you've got to consider Russia have not got the biggest squad. To have the energy to be able to keep going, to keep the skill set high, no matter how much they are absolutely dying inside, is incredible. And then what about that from Kolkova? How she came out with that ball, I really don't know.
Well, it's magic in the cup final from both these sides. It's a slender score here. It's the US that are up 14-10. Russian head coach getting in. Our next game coming up in the cup final, South Africa, who are on an absolute red-hot win streak, looking for their third title in a row this season. They got two last year. They'll take on Argentina. Los Pumas, who have stuck with every side, are such a tough outfit. That is coming up in the next match. Can the Pumas claw their way to victory, or the Blitzbox hold strong? Here's Emily Bidwell for the United States. So thoughts ahead of the second half.
Well, it's going to be whether Russia can keep this intensity up. They've got a bit of a depleted squad, but the way they just finished them, they look strong. For USA, it's going to be about possession. They need to keep hold of the ball, use their power play runners, and get the outside backs then in a bit of space with their speed.
So Russia have been absolutely fantastic. They're at the big dance right now. Never having won the gold yet. Could this be the day? 4 points separates them here in Malaga. It's the second half of the Women's Cup final in the HSBC Spain Sevens here in Malaga. And it's the US Eagles on the left of your screen that lead 14-10 against Russia. I'm Dallin Stanford, joined alongside by former Wales Sevens captain Philippe Tsatiet. And it's been a brilliant 3 days of competition here on the coastline. It sits with the US Eagles. And it comes down to Chris Thomas. Scored a try in the first half. Sarah Levy tries to dig down here. Kershi able to shift it away to Maher. Alona Maher draws a couple. Jazz Gray is on the field. Fresh legs for the US Eagles. Able to keep it in the field of play. That was excellent stuff from the Eagles. Gray comes back to collect yet again. Kershi looking to straighten things up. Takes on three Russian defenders. Fighting to get a knee on the ground to set up a ruck. Levy takes him on. Happy to set up a contact point so they can reload again. Kershi. Russia come flying up. The spot hits need to stick, and they do. They stop the very dangerous Kershi, who hasn't been able to light it up in this final. Driven all the way back. Russia come up. This wall against Levy is holding strong. That's what got them into this final by beating Australia 29-26. Ma flick ball to Kershi. Here comes Kershi with a bit of space. Christy Kershi. And on the outside, it's Jazz Gray. Gray will go the distance, and the US will rock you. It's Gray that has the third score and opens up the second half in style.
Credit to USA for weathering that defensive onslaught from Russia. You were starting to think that potentially Russia might get a turnover. They were just marching them back. They started in their half. They ended up marching the USA back to nearly their 22 with just a solid, connective defensive pressure. But USA didn't panic. They kept hold of the ball. They kept recycling and just trusted that eventually the break will come. They managed to create a short side on the right, got the silky hands to get the ball into space. Really well-worked, good, patient, belief try.
Jazz Gray played with the Raleigh Venom in North Carolina. Another one of those finds coming through the US program. Only in a third event and in a cup final. How about that? The wind will hold this up. Hamidova jumps up and is interfered with, but Rush will get at the halfway line.
scrum.
That would have been a real heavy blow for Russia to concede that try in that position. When you're so dominant in defence, particularly with Russia, they get a lot of confidence from their defensive sets because they're so physical. They really lift them, and that is what gives them the motivation to really be creative and back themselves in attack. So to go through that defensive set then, but still USA managed to angle their way out of it and score a try. That would have hit Russia hard.
11 points the buffer now for the US Eagles, but 4 minutes to go. Russia with Snezhana Kulkova, that scored, debuted in Kitakyushu in 2017.
Set.
Looking to switch direction. Russia coming hard at the angle. Serendina sniping all the way into the 22, but that ball has gone forward. So Jazz Grey has an opportunity to go up, and it's a high shot.
Oh no, disaster for Russia. Referees have been very clear, very consistent, specifically with the high tackles in this tournament. We've seen quite a few yellow cards from it. This is a big ask now for Russia to front up with only six players. Yeah, there's no mitigation there. Jazz Grey is not dipping into contact, stepping into contact. That's as clear as they come yellow.
Daria Shestakova will go to the side for 2 minutes. Very unfortunate for the Russian team and the head coach, Alexeyenko, who's also colourful on the sideline. 3.5 to play in the cup final. Bronze was claimed by Australia that beat France 33 points to 17. So we'll have a new champion in this series for this tournament. Doyle handled on this side. Tapper. Ma looking to have a run herself on the outside. Alona Ma finds Gray. Jazz Gray scored one already. Opens up the stride and opens up the legs. It's the red, white and blue that will go through. And that could be the match winner. It's a double for Jazz Gray in only her third tournament. And a gold medal on the line. No support runners here to force her to put the ball down from Russia. So time is being sucked up and no Russians coming up. Maybe they're not sure. And now here they come. You'll see in picture the Russian player running up here. The US happy to take time off the clock.
Yeah, it is just a bit of a cheeky way of playing the game there. USA being a bit savvy. They're going to run down the clock. They're comfortably in the lead, but equally they're probably feeling very tired. So they're just going to run it down, taking as long as they can on that try. Another lovely, simple hands, done very clinical, very effective. Alona Maya giving a beautifully timed pass to release the winger. Here you go, look. Takes that initial contact, straight away, ball back in two hands, releasing the winger. Lovely bit of execution there.
Magnificent to watch in full flight. And it's the United States with that try. That are up 26 points to 10. It's knocked down here. Conversion was successful. 28-10 it is. Cup finals. New Zealand have won 26, Australia 10, Canada and England 2 each. The US could go for their third here. Tapper on the outside. Naya Tapper getting a strong fend, but they're able to bring her down. Tyrone is over this. Ma comes across field. Playing with such flair and confidence of the US now. Sarah Levy. Hamidova has her as Kershey switches back in field. Kinnett. Just back and forth stuff. So hard to stop. Here they come yet again. Haviland dishes it off to Tapper. It's a game of keep away and Alona Moore comes through. It's about time the Vermont volcano erupts.
Great patience shown there by the USA. The key for them is they're passing the ball from left to right, but it's not just lateral. They're coming onto the ball with pace, with intensity. So they're constantly threatening the Russian defense. They know the Russian players, they're down. They're going to be starting to feel this now. Last couple of seconds, couple of minutes through the last part of the game. So USA have kept hold of the ball, played really clever. Side to side, knowing that eventually that break will come, and it has, and they've exposed it.
The last time the US played in a cup final, the HSBC player of the final was Ilona Ma. That was in Glendale in 2019. And there she is now, adding her name again to the record books. It's powerful from the Americans. 35 points to 10. The siren sounds. Elena Olsen onto the field to restart Russia, that did produce the upset of the tournament against Australia. Succumb to the United States, who are on top of the world. The Americans are the gold medal champions here in Malaga for stop three of the HSBC Spain Sevens. And it is sheer ecstasy for the Eagles.